What happened one morning?
One
at a time, from China.
One morning, the author and his wife came down to breakfast.
You'll get from the report, from the article.
Goods are of poor quality, and the service there is also bad.
The services are intolerable.
Their
services are intolerable. Now, why are Soviet goods so poorly made, and why are their services so bad?
Has degenerated social imperialist.
The Soviet Union, under the Brezhnev rule of the revisionist clique, has degenerated into what? Yes, has degenerated into a social imperialist country.
What do you think of the Russians? Are the Russians really so bad?
Yes, I think the Soviet Union is very bad. Under the rule of the Brezhnev clique.
The revisionist clique.
I think the Soviet Union is no longer a socialist country. It has degenerated into the social imperialist country.
The play, performed so perfectly by the boys of a Peking commune, symbolizes China's defense against an enemy. The enemy is that other vast communist powerhouse, the Soviet Union. While both nations tread a communist path, their characters are very different. While Russian communism has been based on the struggle of the industrial working classes, China's grew from a peasant resistance movement. China claims that Russian communism aims at aggression and domination, while it seeks only classless equality for its people. Even to the outsider, it's a difference that's not difficult to pin down. The roots of Chinese communism lie in the soil. Strong emphasis on efficient, productive agriculture, primitive though it remains, has helped shape the kind of doctrine which guides the people. The Soviet Union is far behind China in food production, but stronger in industry. That industrial society has bred an unspoken hierarchy, managers, skilled workers, laborers. But here in China, everyone must sometime till the soil, and that way, it's claimed, everyone has a common class.